Today marks 13 years since the terrorist attacks of 9/11. Around the country, many are pausing to remember those lost, from the annual ceremony at Ground Zero to memorials in the nation's capital. But after all these years, the threat of radical Islam continues.
Today, the nation pauses to reflect on the worst terror attack ever on U.S. soil. Memorials honoring the lost have become a way of life. In New York at Ground Zero, family members reading the names of each victim lost 13 years ago.
I'm just waiting for the pain to go away.
In Shanksville, Pennsylvania.
Wanda Anita Green.
At the Pentagon. And in the nation's capital, leaders of the House and Senate presented congressional gold medals honoring the fallen heroes of 9/11.
With these medals, we honor the heroism of first responders and ordinary citizens. We remember the perseverance of the loved ones they left behind and the advocacy of the 9/11 families who turned their grief into action to make our nation safer.
In the midst of memorials and ceremonies here in the U.S., another battle rages, with many sounding the alarm about the continued threat of terrorists around the globe.
13 years after 9/11, it's still a dangerous world.
So that threat remains and is constantly there.
Former Vice President Dick Cheney says it's time to get back on the offense in the war on terrorism.
The terrorist threat, far from receding like a tide, has been advancing and multiplying. These are but a few of the features that make the situation today one of the most dangerous we have faced, certainly in my lifetime.
Meanwhile, many changes surround the 9/11 anniversary. One World Trade Center is near completion.
This building's success and height is a sign of the revival and the resurgence of downtown Manhattan and the city and the state and the region to the events of 9/11.
And the 9/11 Museum has opened, and the fences have come down around the Memorial Plaza. In Shanksville, Pennsylvania, a memorial marking the spot where Flight 93 crashed has been set up. All efforts to make sure the nation never forgets.